Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Serge Valcourt for Spiritual Conscience Awareness, which is a show I host on Sunday for you, to awaken your conscience, to awaken your spiritual consciousness, to know your true self. I am Dr. Serge Valcourt. And I am with you again today. And our topic gonna be clean up impurities. Clean up impurities. All right.
One day at a time, sweet Jesus. I'm only human, I'm just a woman, help me believe in what I could be, and all that I am, show me the stairway. Take one day at a time.
What? I am Dr. Serge Valcourt, and our then minister, member of the International Metaphysical Ministry, founder of Spiritual Conscience Awareness. Today again, the Lord give me a chance to be with you, and we're gonna talk about how to clean up impurities. As you know, we all have impurities as humans. Of course, we are not perfect, only God is. Therefore, we need to work on that. That's the effort we do toward that. That will make up a better human being. But some people choose not to work on that. Others try day after day to be better. I am from this side. If you choose to be better day after day, therefore, I am with you, because that's what I do as well, because I know I am human and I am imperfect, I am impure, and therefore, I have to clean up constantly. Internal clean up all the time. That's all we have to do, you and me. That's all we have to do. If we don't do that, we are in the wrong way. I should have to have a car. You buy a great car, brand new, and you never do any cleanup on it. You just drive it every day, go wherever you have to go, do whatever you have to do, and just no concern about the vehicle. Believe me, after a year or over a year, it will break, because you never do any cleanup on it. You don't clean it up. You have to do that for yourself as well, because we have a lot of impurities. And our role is to get rid of them and close the door to not let more impurities get in. And that's what gonna help you know God. To know God, we must become one with Him. But, as you know, fusion can only occur between objects of or beings of the same essence. Let me say that again. If two objects are not the same essence, there cannot be fusion. It is the same. To know God, you have to cultivate within you its essence. Then you're gonna be of the same essence with Him. If you are not from the same essence, you cannot be one with Him. Or we are here on earth to grow and to, while we are here, our mission is to become one with God. For instance, take a small amount of mercury, scatter it in chocolate, then bring them close together, the mercury and the droplets. Bring them close together. Once again, they unite to form a single drop. Understand? If you take a small amount of mercury, scatter it in droplets, then bring them close together again. Once again, they unite to form a single drop. But now, suppose that before gathering the droplets together again, you give a chance for a little dust to fall on them. No matter what you do next, they will remain separate from the other. Because of that dust. Because of the dust, they will not form one piece of single drop. It is the same for you. If you let some dust inside of yourself, how can you expect to be one with God, which is perfect? Of course, it creates us to be one with Him. But He creates us as well to not let impurities take over us. If you happen to do so, it's up to you to get rid of impurities in order for you to be one with God. Humans wish to unite with the universal consciousness without first purifying themselves. How can that happen? As long as they remain impure, evil, and dark, they cannot connect with the Creator. It's not possible to get connection with the Creator if you remain impure with an evil mind. That thought. If You have tendencies to do bad things to others. If you have tendencies to talk wrong about others, how can you become one with the Creator? Therefore, to rid yourself of the layers of impurity preventing disunion, you must make certain sacrifices which require mastering yourself and changing your vices to the opposite qualities. Only on this condition can you begin to attune yourself with the divine. Brothers and sisters, you cannot wake up one day and find yourself attuned with the divine. This requires some sacrifice. Some sacrifice like mastering yourself. If you don't know yourself, mastering yourself means know your true self. Be in control of yourself. When you are in control of yourself, you have a chance to transform any vices into the opposite qualities. That's the way you clean up impurities and turn internal impurities. That's the way to clean them up. Mastering yourself, that means be in control of yourself. If you are in control of yourself, you know your true self. If you can do that, you are in a good path of knowing who you are. Or you cannot become one with God if you don't know who you are. If you don't know who you are, you cannot make any cleanup, any internal cleanup. We do not always have the opportunity to travel on a road still. That's life. The road is not always still in front of you. Our path is sometimes full of stones. But in the middle of any trouble, you must find your way out, transforming a grimace of hate into a smile of happiness. But, folks, while crossing dangerous path, it is best for you to walk away from people who put you down and not get involved in unresolved fight. This will not serve you. This will not help you in anything great. Let me say that again. When you are making effort to do internal cleanup, you need to walk away from people who put you down. And also, you must not get involved in unresolved fight will not help you do better in your life at all. It is also good not to please your ego and people who reject your worth. You know, some people are always there to reject your effort, to devaluate you, reject your worth. You must walk away of this kind of people in order for you to progress spiritually. Even materially, to progress, there should be some kind of people to stay away from, but spiritually requires that. It requires that you do not do things to please your ego. You do not do anything to please your ego, because ego is evil. Don't do what ego requires you to do, because ego is evil. And also, walk away from people who don't know your worth, reject you. Just walk away from them, because they're not going to be helpful for you to grow spiritually. Do your best to walk away from toxic individual. Not let them destroy your inner peace. You need your inner peace to spiritually grow. But if you mix yourself within them, within toxic individual, you will never get your inner peace. And not getting your inner peace is impossibility to clean up. It's impossibility to clean up impurities within you. Therefore, it will also help to put in mind that adversities are temporary situations. Therefore, prepare yourself to build windmills when the wind of change blows in your favor, to grab opportunities as they come. Therefore, it is good to keep your heart open to love and compassion, and your mind ready to spread peace around you. Let me say that again. In order for you to clean up impurities, you have to put in mind that adversities are temporary. Remember that as long as we are traveling in this journey, there will be good time, there will be bad time. There will be time of happiness, time for adversities. But if you put in mind that adversities are temporary situations, you will deal better with them. You must always prepare yourself to build windmills, when the wind of change blows in your favor. You must be ready to grab opportunities as they come. You must keep your heart open to love and compassion, and your mind ready to spread peace around you. Always, brothers and sisters, always follow this step in order for you to go better in order for you to clean impurities. Remember, if your path is full of stone, instead of complaining about your tragedy, seek your inner strength to challenge the adversities. Let me repeat this again. If you find your path full of stones, don't stay there complaining, "Oh God, why me? Why is my path full of stones?" This will not help you. What you must do is to seek inner strength to challenge, transforming the stone into something valuable, into something helpful to you. That's all you must do instead of staying complaining. Remember that complaining, crying will not do better to your life. Always trust God to provide you with the ability to overcome disaster. Anyone can get drained in disasters at any moment because we are in a journey. It's not an easy journey. You can expect to get disaster at any moment. But with your trust in God, you will get the ability to overcome any disaster. That's all you must do. But to be able to overcome disaster, you must first clean up impurities. And that's your mission. Thank you for listening. Thank you for following. Thank you for sharing. You must share it because this kind of messages are very hard to listen to because people who know the truth will not tell you the truth. They will not tell you the truth for some reason, for their personal reason. But I am here for you. Please share it. I am on Facebook. I am on Twitter and on YouTube. If you type my name, Dr. Serge Falco, on YouTube, you will get all my messages. And if you go to my name on Facebook, especially if you go to Spiritual Conscious Awakeness, you will get all my messages. I am also on Twitter. Please share it because humanity needs to change. And change will not happen if we don't make effort to clean up, to do internal cleanup. There will be no change, and humanity need change. Without change, if I don't change, if I stay the same, if you stay the same, if everybody stay the same, how can we expect a world to change better? And God sent us here to make a paradise on earth. Thank you so much. It was Dr.
Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never come.